Hi everyone, Michael here from Economics Explained, and if the name reveal wasn't enough to give it away, this is not going to be an ordinary episode. It is, however, probably going to be one of the most important videos that we have ever made. Normally, we work hard to shed light on policies, theories, ideas, laws, and history from the perspective of a cold-hearted economist because that is often the most transparent way to understand the true motivations behind any of these things. Times of crisis, like the dumpster fire that is 2020, serve as a great distraction for the rollout of policies that would have, under any normal circumstances, not seen the light of day due to fear of criticism by cold-hearted economists or any rational person for that matter. The News Media Bargaining Code is a proposed piece of legislation currently under review by the Australian Parliament that would work to effectively abolish the level playing field of the internet within the country. Now, for all of you watching that are not Australian, don't breathe a sigh of relief because this will still impact you. For reference, and in the interest of full disclosure, Economics Explained does have an Australian audience, but it only makes up about 7% of our viewership. So short term, this would hurt us, but not very much. Long term though, the implications are devastating to everybody. But this is still an episode of Economics Explained, so let's take a look at the economics of this issue. News media from large organisations like News Corp, WarnerMedia, and Walt Disney Television are very important. These organisations have the resources to put investigators onto stories all around the world and report on events that we may have otherwise been unaware of. Nobody is going to argue against the importance of the media. But these large organisations are exactly that, large companies with huge overheads that cost a lot to run. Therefore, as their viewers increasingly migrate away from television and to sites like YouTube, they are no longer able to make as much revenue as they used to, simply because there is more competition for free content. On Australian free-to-air television, there are 5 primary news channels. On YouTube, there may be thousands of channels commenting on similar issues that are all equally free to view. This means that advertising revenue is spread far thinner, and in a realistic future where more people are watching YouTube than are watching TV, this means that this type of business model would no longer be fiscally viable. So what was their solution? Cut down on overheads, move to a more decentralized business model, make more broadly appealing content? No. It was to lobby the government into passing this law, which would give them back the oligopoly they once enjoyed, where your choices of news coverage were TV, newspaper, or the crazy guy on his soapbox. The law would do this by mandating that registered media organisations would have key insights into how Google's backend systems work, e.g., what it is that makes YouTube put a video on their homepage versus what it is that doesn't. This is unbelievably alarming because it would give them the keys to ensure that the only thing a viewer will ever see is the content that they produce. And that doesn't necessarily stop with just the news. It would be naive to think that these companies would be given the key to the algorithm and not use it for every single bit of content that they produce, journalistic or otherwise. The next part of the legislation would give these organisations exclusive access to specific user data, which they could then use to determine trends, discern insights, and target specific viewers. Privacy concerns aside, this would mean that viewers would be selectively targeted with articles that are particularly agreeable to them, missing the opportunity to present arguments that might help fill out a more well-informed opinion. Australian media outlets don't make too much of a secret of the fact that they are conservative. They are mostly owned by conservative public figures, and their reporting is pretty blatantly in support of Australia's more conservative party. Now, this is actually fine. They are private companies, and they are well within their rights to publish whatever it is that they want to, so long as it's not intentionally misleading or false. What is not fine is when there is no platform for alternative views to be heard, especially if that is achieved by taking away the platform that is doing exactly this. These organisations know that YouTube is not their home field packed to the brim with their best supporters. That's why, for almost all of their videos, comments are turned off and ratings are hidden. Even still, they are more than welcome on the platform. They are just not welcome to own the platform. Finally, we would be remiss if we didn't mention the money. Currently, news organisations operating in Australia make about $10 million US in revenue every year on YouTube. This is, of course, a lot of money. It is actually an unbelievable amount of money considering that most of these outlets get less views and have fewer subscribers than, say, Economics Explained, for example. Regardless of this, these organisations want to mandate that Google and similar platforms would pay at least $600 million per year towards them, or put another way, they would have to pay 60 times what their business relationship is currently worth. It should go without saying that this is a dangerous precedent, not only for fair media coverage, but more so for how we conduct business. It is unfathomable that an organisation can be mandated into handing over money simply because the recipient is masquerading as a public service. Now, this is why it's so important to everyone. Most of the media organisations we have discussed are owned by international companies. If this can be rolled out in Australia, which is normally pretty politically savvy, you better believe that they will roll it out everywhere. It would be incredibly foolish of them not to do so. Unfortunately, and probably deliberately, this has all been rolled out in the midst of one of the most difficult years of our lives. So, it has easily flown under the radar. And even at the best of times, this kind of story is not exactly going to make headlines, is it? So, it's up to us. We don't individually wield as much political influence as these companies, but collectively, we can still make our voice heard. Find the link in the video description and sign the petition on our change.org campaign. Share this video, feel free to copy and repost it, share your opinions on it, and feel free to disagree with me over it. But most importantly, make people aware of it. We at Economics Explained are going to continue to forward this petition onto every member of Parliament and the Senate. So the more signatures we get, the more weight our words will hold. We are also going to forward our concerns to the Australian Competition and Consumer Commission, which is supposedly Australia's anti-competitive watchdog, a watchdog that is evidently asleep at the wheel. They specifically request not to reach out to their officers, so naturally, we would encourage you all to do so. Contact details are on the screen now. YouTube and Google are not perfect. They are filled with people you might not agree with, personalities that you may not like, and success stories that you may not care for, but it's our YouTube. Everyone gets a chance to have their voice heard. Of course, some get an audience and some don't, but that's okay because everyone can have a go and everyone has a chance. If this bill was to pass, and it might only be a month away, this would no longer be our YouTube. Even the best, most talented, most entertaining, or most enlightened individuals would not get the opportunity to rise to the top and would instead be strategically buried under content from media organisations. Now, some of this big company content would be good, some of it would be bad, but it would no longer be up to us to decide what is what. If this bill passes, it would no longer be our YouTube.